Hey, what's up, guys? Welcome to another episode of Subnautica. Today we're going to be doing something I've been really looking forward to, and that is exploring the Aurora once again. But this time, I will equip myself with that gravity gun. I know it's not the name, but whatever. The fire extinguisher, and we're actually going to go in there and see what we can find. So yeah, I'm really excited. Let's get started. Okay, guys, we are here in the base that we built last episode, and we're going to go ahead and get some gear together to go towards the Aurora, of course, trying to stay away from the creepers. Not creepers, reapers. So yeah, after we get out, what I'm planning to do is make a battery charger and a stasis rifle, because both of these things we do need. But I am running a little low on silver for the advanced wiring kit, the computer chip. But I'll be fine. So let me get some stuff together to go towards the Aurora, and we'll go. I think we are ready. Some of our stuff is kind of low on power, but we're not going to need that much power anyway. So yeah, guys, really our main objective here is we just need to stay away from the Reaper. And we'll pretty much be good. Now, the only thing is that I don't want to go during the nighttime. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to wait until daytime and then we're going to go. Alright, it is light out. Let's go. What I'm going to try to do, stay near the surface. And be careful, I guess. I'm actually not even going to go underwater. I'm just going to stay above water and get there. Yeah, we'll make our way around to the front of the Aurora and we'll start doing stuff. And yeah, it's notorious that Reapers roam around the Aurora. So I gotta pray that there's not one near here. Alright, we've made it into the Aurora safely. So that's good. Let's see, can we enter through here with the gravity gun? I don't know if I went through here yet. So let's move this stuff out of the way. Last box. Oh, we can just throw that. Bam. Alright, let's go in. And we can use a fire extinguisher here. Oh, ow, ow. Why am I on fire again? Okay. What is this place? Okay, it goes down into something. Okay, I guess we'll check this out first then. Let's get our scanner tool out. Oh, electrical things. Pick that up. Can I get through here? Cut to open. Oh, I think I might need the laser cutter. And here I need a code. Oh, no, I don't have the code. Okay, well, we're gonna have to go look for a code. And we should probably make a laser cutter for that. Does this do anything? Doesn't look like it. Alright guys, here's what we're gonna do. We gotta go back. We gotta grab some laser cutters, sadly, so gotta go back. And on the way back, there's a life raft. Right. Can I get on it? No? Oh. Well, that guy's swim charge fins. Oh boy, let's go. Yeah, that guy's dead. What's going on here? Is there like something we could? Oh, spooky. Oh, I think that's something bad. Let's check what's in here. Disaffected water. I'll take it. Okay, so while we're here, we're actually going to make a couple of things real quick. Let's replace the batteries in both of these. So bam, there's a good battery, and bam, there's a good battery. We can stick our old batteries in here. And then we need to make the laser cutter. That is one thing that we do have to make. Laser cutter, which is right, I saw it, which is right over here. Diamond, battery, and titanium. Okay, well, we can get all of those. So diamond, titanium, maybe the next one, and a battery, which to make a battery, you need two of these and a copper ore. All right, guys, and with that, we're also going to make the battery charger. So I have all the materials right here for everything that we need. So let's go over here. What we have to make is one computer chip, which this has to do with the battery, I think. So deployables, personal tools. All right, so I figured out why it wasn't working. It is because we need the habitat builder to actually get the battery charger, which is my bad. So we can go to interior. And yeah, it is right here, the battery charge knot. Ooh, this is actually pretty big, but that is fine. Let's place that right here, I guess. And then we'll stick four chargers in here. Bam, just like that. And we could place this back in here. Now we won't have to keep making batteries. We'll just be able to recharge them over and over again. So I'm going to grab some batteries and let's do it. Okay, so, oh, 1, 2, 3, 4, there we go. Cool. I like that. And then we could also drink the water and the health. Cool. Okay, guys, just gonna eat some food real quick. And we got everything with us pretty much. So we can go ahead and get back to it. Hey, what's up, guys? So this is like 2 hours after this. I'm editing right now and I've realized something. A second ago you saw a clip of me dying by a Reaper because I was actually talking to my dad because he walked in and needed help with some internet, and I muted myself for this, but I never actually unmuted myself, so I'm obviously not gonna leave from 8 minutes to 24 minutes completely silent because that would be stupid. So I'm going to be narrating over this. Now, I don't think it's such a bad thing, to be honest. From here, I'll be able to give you more insight on what I'm doing or laugh at myself for stupid things that I'm doing in the video. So right now, we're going deeper into the Aurora by breaking open that door with the wire cutter that we just made. So let's continue. Of course, we get some chests. It seems like every chest in this game is filled with a battery, but this is kind of like the beginning starting room right here, and you'll see me in a second jump cut to this
Aurora team,
and we'll listen
minutes.
To this.
This is an emergency distress call. Aurora is on collision course with planet 45460.
That's not good.
Sending all available environmental data. Please find survival solution. ALTERRAHQ.
Which is what we're doing now.
To any survivors of the starship Aurora. If you're hearing this, we will do everything in our power to get you home. A rescue mission would take years to reach you out there, but we think we've got a better solution. ALTERRAHQ, T+8 hour. We received your environmental data, and we've sent you a blueprint for a specially designed ship we think will be capable of breaking orbit and getting you back to the nearest phase gate. We calculate that you can find the requisite materials in situ. We'll be sure to stand.
And that is the energy pulse origin in front of us.
Communications relay offline.
Okay, so we have to go to that, but of course we're not going to do that right now. We're going to explore the rest of the Aurora, and in a second. Electricity hurts you guys. This is what I mean by stupid things that I do. right there. I walk in electricity, which is very fun. Like, this I'm great at this game, clearly. And here is the main, I think it's called the Prawn Bay. You could actually go scan those prawn machines over there and get the prawn things. And I'll get those later in the episode. I didn't get them right now, and right now we're repairing to open this door. But yeah, I will get those prawn things, don't worry. I know, I got them. But I'll get them later on. So let's open this door, get rid of the fire. So this door opens up another hallway to, I think, two rooms. This opens up to one room, I think the reactor room, where you could stop actually leaks, which we'll do that later, and another room, which I forgot, so I guess we will go and see that. But yes, one of the rooms we will visit in a second is kind of the reactor room. Over there you can take your repair tool and fix up. There's going to be giant towers there, I was going to see. And once you fix those up, radiation actually goes away from the world. So we don't even need our radiation suit anymore, I don't think. I don't think. It'll say radiation goes away, so I don't know if that means... And this is a weird glitch right here. For some reason, music plays right there. The second I get out, it goes away. Very weird. Subnautica needs to fix itself, but, I mean, it's been a great game. I'm still playing it, so... And right now, what we're doing is just kind of scavenging the room, picking up anything we can get soon, and we will break through that door once we get this little piece of information. Aurora Auxiliary Orders. So yeah, we are going to break through this door right here, and I think beyond this is like the reactor room, where we have to stop the leaks, I'm pretty sure. And by the way, while recording this episode, I've actually had to go back to like the base a couple times, because I always either die or hydration or I run out of battery. So I've been back already a couple times. I'm not exactly sure when. Okay, so this is kind of the main hallway, and this hallway splits into two. This is one of them, and straight forward is another one. You'll see me kind of turn around right here, kind of wanting to know what the other place is first. So I kind of get the feeling of both rooms and which one should I explore first here. And beyond here is, oh, okay, so yeah. To the side is a reactor room. Over here, this is kind of just an empty room, but beyond that door is a Seamoth Bay, I think. And we can actually... Yeah, so beyond this is a Seamoth door, but we're going to take a look at that later. For now, let's go ahead and go to the reactor room. But you got to remember, while I was recording this, I didn't know this was the reactor room. And for a while, I didn't even know what I did in there until I somehow pulled out my repair tool and fixed something kind of by sheer coincidence, and I ended up kind of finding out what to do. But you'll see me here grab something for the Cyclops. I don't know if it's an upgrade or something. Power efficiency module. So I think that is an upgrade. See, after this, I just kind of run around for a while until I pull out my repair gun, and I'm like, whoa, you can repair these. Because I heard before of something about fixing the leaks in the Aurora, and I never knew. So it was just kind of like an accident finding this out. So yeah, for the next like 4 or 5 minutes, we're just going to go ahead and find all the things that we need to repair. The repair tool, and I have plenty of power, so that's not a problem. Now, a lot of these are kind of hidden away. Out of the, I forgot if there was like 12... But like 8 of them are probably underground. There's 2 of them on top where kind of picked up that Cyclops module. Yeah, so that's really about most of them right there. Some of them are really high, really low, but they're all in this room. So kind of spoiler towards the future of the episode, but I need something to talk about. So the things that are left for us to take care of is, of course, the Seamoth Bay, which we will get. I think it's like the last thing we get. We got to get Prawn Bay and pick up all the prawn suits, which we were at. We just didn't get up the prawn suits. And above the Prawn Bay, there is a living quarters. In that living quarters, we need to scavenge all the rooms. And then there's 2 rooms with codes on them. We can get into one of the room with a code. And the other one doesn't have a code yet in-game. It does. It's just a room that does nothing. So we're just not going to have anything to deal with it. But yeah, I think the main quest for Aurora is kind of coming in here, finding all these parts, fixing the radiation, and then yeah, we picked up the Aurora Black Box, or whatever it's called, and that leads us towards an energy pulse origin. I have no idea what that is, but I know I said it in the episode, but obviously it's muted so you can't hear it, but next episode we will go ahead and do that. And another small spoiler, at the end of this episode, we will build the Seamoth. So next episode, what we're going to do is we're going to try to get as many materials together, see if we can build the prawn suit or the cyclops if we find it, which hint, we don't, which it might be over at the energy pulse thing. I have no idea. Yeah, that's what kind of next episode is going to focus around, is that place. And I know I just talked over all of that, but what that robot lady voice just said is radiation's gone. It'll be completely gone in 3 days. And you can see we are back at the base. And in about 3 seconds, you'll see another jump cut at the prawn base. Now you can see I'm going to be taking care of some of the fire and trying to pick up some of the prawn suits. So I think we're going to grab 2 or 3 of them. I'm not sure. I know I leave one engulfed in fire, which we'll get later. And then those ones hanging from the sky, I didn't know we could get until the end of the episode, so we'll get that later on. But there are 2 right there, and we do need 4. There's one on fire, one we can grab off the building, but again, we will get that a little bit later on. For now, yeah, here I was trying to figure out how to get up the stairs, and I did use a gravity gun to get rid of those, but right after, I practically had to leave to go back to the base. After the base, we come back in here, and I quickly explore this room to the left with a code. And honestly, this room kind of disappointed me. There was really nothing in here, and the code is 6483. All they really did was pick up one of those lab experiment decorations. Yeah, there's really nothing in here. I think that there might have been some like water or something, and a crate that was stuck inside of another crate. Which I did end up getting. I didn't show it on video, but I didn't end up getting it. And now we are back in the main hallway. So these bleeder things kind of stick to you and suck your blood out. One of them actually killed me earlier. They're called bleeders. But if we come over here, this is where the Seamoth Bay is. If we fix this door, we will be introduced. And I already fixed it halfway earlier when a bleeder actually killed me. And you could see that is a part of the Seamoth, and I did get another half of the Seamoth while I was outside exploring. So that's, we got one half, and we just needed this part. In a second, you'll see me scan the Seamoth fragment, and this is the other half of the fragment that we actually needed. Actually, there's 3. My bad. I got one outside, and those 2 is the ones that we needed, and now we got the Seamoth. And in the video, I was super excited, like, oh, we got the Seamoth finally, blah, 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 blah. Yeah, the Seamoth is actually really cool, though. We build it at the end, it's a lot of fun. So now what we're going to do is check out the living quarters. So these are like rooms, restaurants, things like that. So in here, what you're going to see me do is pick up that piece of paper. We're going to scan, oh, a lot of things actually in here. That lab is scannable. That shelf is scannable. There's going to be a poster we pick up, and if you see at the corner of the room, there's a vending machine. I scan that later on, so don't worry, I don't forget it. But yeah, I didn't know that was scannable. I don't know why. I knew I saw a vending machine. I was really excited about it in the crafting menu. But yeah, we will pick that up later. But for now, we got to scan this wall shelf. Bloop. And you know what's cool? There's 2, like, or 3 different wall shelves, but, like, the scanning transfers over, which is kind of interesting, I noticed, and I just had a voice crack. I'm talking a lot. Anyway, so, yeah, we could pick up this poster, and we actually hang it up in our room later, which is very exciting. And another fire extinguisher, that's exactly what I needed to get the other pieces of the prawn suit, which will help us, of course, fight stuff, which is quite a lot of fun. So, yeah, we're here at the prawn suit, putting the fire out, and yeah, we'll be able to scan it. But guys, I think I'm kind of enjoying this, talking over the video, because I think it gives a lot more insight. Now, of course, I'm not going to do this, because I don't think this is how gameplay should be met. I think I should record my first reactions and upload it, but this is a cool, fun little change. Hopefully, you guys like it. I do like when my original reactions are on here, though, but it's okay, this is good, a little insight. So there are 4 pieces of the prawn suit. We got 3 right there, and we'll get another one that's hanging from the sky. But we haven't properly actually delved into the living quarters yet, and that's what we're going to be doing right now. So the room over here is kind of like a food storage. There's a lot of hydrated like water bottles, or cleaned water bottles. So we end up just grabbing all of them. And we actually do drink a couple, and there are a couple protein blocks in here. Now, I don't know if the protein blocks are craftable. I saw on a Reddit post that they weren't. I saw that they were craftable, but apparently not. So to our left is two rooms, and to our right is a couple rooms. The two to our left have codes on them. Over here, they have no codes, and we actually can't scan a bed, which I'm pretty excited about. Now we can have a bed in our room, but we'll get to those two rooms, I think, around last, and I accidentally pulled out my fire extinguisher. And there is a narrow bed, and there's actually different types of bed. Later on, we actually scan a different type of bed, which is kind of exciting. And I think there's another poster in here. Yes, we can grab that poster. And of course, we will hang that up in our base sooner or later. And it also, an interesting thing, if you look at every room, there's a locker just like that, and it has the same photo of the same girl. I was just kind of making a joke how everybody in this world is apparently cheating on each other, because they all have the same picture of the same girl. So I think these guys have an issue that they need to work out here. But yeah, if we go in this room, we find a little toy thing. I didn't even realize I grabbed it, because I actually didn't see it. That's the funny thing. I didn't even know what I grabbed until I kind of looked at it, which is up there, the Arcade George toys. We will, of course, put that in the house when we get there. And the living quarters is kind of the last thing we explore, because like you've seen, we explored the Prawn Bay, we explored the Seamoth Bay. We're in the living quarters now as we finish this. We patched up the leaks. We're pretty much done with the Aurora after this, so that's pretty exciting. A big part of this. And here's another bed that we can scan. We just scanned a bookshelf, or just a shelf. But yeah, I'm actually kind of excited to never come back here again, because I hate Aurora. There's Reapers running around here, and they scare me, and I don't like them. But if there is something that we forgot in here, of course I will come back in a later episode to get it. I'm not going to just not forget about it. But yeah, so far I've gotten eaten by the Reapers twice, which is no fun. The first time it was an actual jump scare. It scared the living out of me. And the second time, I kind of knew it was coming. I watched it grab me. Oh, and there's the vending machine that I was talking about earlier. Yeah, the second time I kind of let it get to me because I was talking to my dad and I had really no choice. Well, I had a choice, but I just, like, you know, I'm a nice person, you know. And in a second here, jump cut, we come to the prawn suit. Get the prawn suit. And I'm pretty sure we head back to the ocean and start heading towards the base. Yep, here you can see me putting down that George toy. And also, a big part of the video here was actually the crafting of the Seamoth here. But of course, I had no talking, so I pretty much just cut it all out. So we are here building the Seamoth, and yes, I did have to get the lubricant, the glass, and all that kind of stuff on video, but I'm just not going to include it. So this is the Seamoth. It is a little portable water thingy. It has energy and health. The cool thing is, you don't get hurt by a lot of things, like the poison gas from these animals you don't get hurt from, and things like those shark things in the creep biome do not hurt you. Okay guys, so I have been muted for the longest time because someone came in my room and I forgot to unmute myself. So that's great. So I guess I gotta talk about everything that's been going on. We built the Seamoth. I really hope I wasn't muted for too long. So we did build the Seamoth, which is really cool. That is outside. And I don't know how this episode's going to go. I don't know how I'm going to edit it because, yeah, I don't have sound half the time. That's why I hate muting myself, because I always end up forgetting it. But we did make the Seamoth, which is really, really, really cool. So I don't know what more to say about it. For next episode, I will try to get silver and quartz to build stuff next episode. We're also going to be going to that energy place, the signal. We're going to be going to that. But yeah, guys, today we explored the Aurora and we got the Seamoth, which is really cool. And also, we're going to be building the Prawn and the Cyclops soon once we find the parts, like the Rainforest Dive suit also, and the Still suit and all that kind of stuff. So let's head to the main menu. Let's, of course, save the game. And yeah, hopefully I didn't mute too much of myself. I think I muted quite a lot, to be honest, which isn't good. But yeah, guys, hopefully you guys enjoyed. If you did, make sure to like and a comment as it supports my channel, and I'll see you guys later. God bless and goodbye.